I am live. Holy crap. You know, it's only when you see yourself on camera that you realize how bad you look. I once went to a visagist and he said, "Honey, you need bangs. You cannot go without life. No, you can't go in life without bangs." And I hate them so much with a passion. I hate them. So here's what happened. I had a video. It was a live video. And it went through the whole processing thing, and then it went live, and so some people watched it, and then I saw that it was still processing in another part, so I thought, well, that's stupid, so I'll just delete the other parts that's apparently still processing, and it deleted the whole thing, both of them. So that's how smart I am. And I think we're going to kind of spend the afternoon together. Is it the afternoon? No, it's not. It's still the morning. But how about we spend the day together? Come on, my boo. Come on, my boo. Come on, my boo. Come on, my boo. Yeah, my boo. Yeah, boo. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you are my boo-boo. You are my friend. Okay, yeah, he's gone. All right. So, I've never been a minimalist, per se. But I've never liked clutter. And I have clutter. And these are things that have that should have their own places, but at the moment they don't. I'll give you an example. Well, so the thing is, I'm wearing shoes. Excuse me, I'm wearing shoes right now because I was supposed to go out, but I never wear shoes inside the house, because I'm so afraid of stepping on Bobo. So, but I do want to go out just for a second. So what do I do? Anyway. All right. Things that need their own space. My African necklaces. This is a tissue. This is, I went to Muji and I went hog wild. I bought all the bedding. And the thing is, these are for the pillows that are like 60-40. Yeah, Bobo. And I don't have those kind of pillows, and I need to replace all my pillows. So I have two of those big, is it 60 by 60 pillows, 80 by 80, who gives a shit? Those square pillows, right? So I have those, but they're so uncomfortable and so worn out that I seriously need new pillows. And I also need new, like, rectangular pillows, and that's what these covers are four. So I'm keeping these and they're going into the cupboard. And the cupboard has no rhyme or reason. It just does not. It does not, does it? No, it doesn't. So stop showing people your ass. God, I'm gonna have to put you on OnlyFans. Yeah, you. Oh, my precious. Oh, he's hugging me. Oh, my God, he's hugging me. Ugh. So, now he's attacking my shoe. That's fine. Thank you for the thumbs up. You know how I appreciate that, even if you can't stick around. So here's the plan. This is what I figured out. I was supposed to, this is what I said before, right? I was gonna go to the Jardin des Tuileries and show you the Christmas market. Well, it's a Wednesday, and I hate leaving the house. I mean, I hate leaving the house. The only reason I leave the house in the mornings is because I know that I need to make money to feed Bobo and to provide him with kitty litter and with anything else that he needs, like vet bills. Talking about the kitty litter, oh my God, what a debacle. What a debacle. Do not buy the cheap shit. Just don't do it. Don't. Hi, Jeanette. Hi, Jeanette. So fortunately, I still have a bag of the expensive stuff, but I need to clean out the... What are you doing? What? He's obsessed with my shoe. I don't know what's going on. So, I'm not going to the Christmas market today. What I will do, and this is a real promise, you have trouble with anxiety, you hate leaving the house too. Oh my God. Unless it's, right, unless it's like a matter of life and death, like you're out of food in the house, or one of your animals needs something, then I wouldn't call it agoraphobia. I would call it just the anxiety of having to meet the other people in the street, the strangers, and then potentially dealing with any situation that may come along. Like, it's so, you know, I take public transport every day. And, like, yesterday, there was this, oh my God, there was this asshole with his wife. And he's like, oh, my wife is pregnant, na na na. And everybody has to make space for my pregnant wife. She wasn't even showing. She wasn't even showing. And he's like, oh, you move this, you move that. And the guy pushed an old lady. And so, and everybody's like, con. Con in French means... ass, jackass, but it con, like if you say vrai con, like a true ass, that's a very serious thing to say to somebody. It's something serious. And so like people were getting off, ah vrai con, ah t'es con, and then the same guy, there was a woman with a pram with her baby, and he just pushed the pram, and she's like, what the hell are you doing? And he's like, well, people are getting off and my wife is pregnant and all that. And she's like, I've got a baby and a pram, watch what you're doing. And he's like, oh, fuck you. I don't drive right now. I take public transport too, or I use Uber. Oh, yeah. Oh, no. No, no. I mean, listen. In general, Parisians are polite. They are very accommodating to people. When you have to get off, they try to make space as much as possible. You have to get off. It's rush hour traffic. Everybody understands that everybody is stressed, and we all need to get on and we all need to get off, and everybody understands this. It's just that once in a while you get a bad egg, you know, once in a while, and it's just situations like that. I used to be extremely anxious about getting on and off the metro, but it was so bad. When the metro would come and the doors opened and I saw the group of people, and there were times when I just couldn't get on, and there were times when I couldn't go to work, and then there were times when I actually got to work and it was rush hour traffic and I had to get off, and I was planning 3 stops ahead of my own stop. I was planning, oh my God, I have to say, excuse me. I have to say, excuse me. I have to say, excuse me. And it was going through my head. It was just insane. And the whole thing was just in my head, because people in general, Parisians, are very understanding. That's like, for them, it's nothing. You have to get off. There's no space. Okay, listen, let me get off the metro, and then you can get off, and then I'll get back on. It's not an issue. It's not an issue. It's just something that was in my head, you know? You're a Japanese-American, and they are the same way. They're usually very polite. Oh, I had no idea you're Japanese-American. I thought you were just American-American. Yeah, and there was a... once on the metro, there was a Japanese lady with a baby in her sling. And she was like... I thought she was like, you know what? I'm so used to the Parisian... whatever, public transport. So the metro was completely full, right? And I had a seat. And she got on and she just stood right by the front door, and she was holding onto the thing. She was holding onto her baby, and she was just standing like that. And so I got up and I held my one leg. I held my one leg across my seat, because I didn't want some other asshole to go and grab my seat. And I tapped her on the shoulder and I said, excuse me, would you like to have a seat? And she said, oh, thank you very much. And she took the seat. And she bowed down to me, and she was very nice. But it was... because listen, Parisians can be polite, but the moment you give up your seat, it is gone. It is gone. Someone else takes it. Yeah. So anyway, we were talking about anxiety, and you know, it's, I don't know, in general, I hate talking to people. In general, I hate interacting with people. The nicest interactions I have is with people in shops, you know, like the sellers. They're always so nice and polite and smiling and friendly, and I just, that's my best interaction. If you have a regular bus driver, same thing. He smiles. He's like, hey, how are you doing? But the idea of getting dressed and putting on your makeup and doing your hair and leaving the front door and going out It's just the idea of going out, I think. Because once I'm out, Boo-Boo is in his... And I have to change his litter. Oh my God. I have to go back to the expensive litter. Anyway, going out. So this is what's going to happen, okay? Friday, I have my shrink appointment. It's at 4 o'clock. So after the shrink appointment, and he's got a dog. Oh my God. It's my shrink. Okay, so this is completely normal. He got the most expensive dog from the most expensive breeder in Italy. That's my shrink, okay? So, but the dog, he's a sausage dog. Oh my God, he's adorable. He's so cute. He's 10 months old. So now I'm like, you know what? Now I'll just come back every week just to see Marcello. Because the first time I met him and I was with Marcello in his little area space, and my shrink goes, Eva, I am the psychiatrist, and you're here to see me, and you're paying me because I am working here. And I said to him, Please, Marcello is the most important entity in this entire universe right now. So you can just sit there, read a newspaper, do whatever, go on your phone, watch a video. I don't care. I'm busy with Marcello. That's it. That was my last visit with my shrink. So he's just so cute. So... the session is usually half an hour long, and I will go straight from the shrink to Jardin des Tuileries. And once I'm out, when it comes to anxiety, you know, once I'm out for a specific thing, then I can do everything else, you know? It's doing one thing each day that really gets to me. So, that's it. I gotta do some stuff. I gotta clean the place. You know what? Does insurance in France cover the psychiatrist? Yes, it does. Yes, it does. There are different levels of therapy in France. So there is a therapist. They're actually called a therapist. There is a psychologist, and there is a psychiatrist. The psychiatrist is a professional medical doctor who is the only one who is allowed to prescribe medication. So the medical insurance covers that. The other two are not covered because they can't provide medication. Yeah, it is great. I can't tell you how lucky I am. And there were times when I was unemployed, and things were really, really bad, I heard insurance in the US is a nightmare. I heard. I don't know how you people survive. I honestly don't know. But when I was unemployed and I didn't have medical insurance, and I told my shrink, and he said, you know what, just come, it's fine, we'll figure it out. And for, I want to say, maybe 6 months, maybe 8 months, when I was unemployed, I would go to him twice a month, because I really needed it, and he never charged me. And he was like, you know what? It's fine. You are my charity work. Let's just keep it at that. So I never paid him a dime for 6 or 8 months. And he never got anything. We have a very... I'm so lucky that I found him, that he is such a good person, you know? So there are things that I have to do. I have to put away the washing. I need a maid. I need a housekeeper. I need to do my passion planner. I need to organize my DVDs. I need to put away my makeup and jewelry. I need to get some more wine because it's a fucking Wednesday. So I'm getting wine. I don't care. And Thursday is... Boo-boo! Hi, precious. Hey, precious. I was just talking to my neighbor because we decided to share the internet. So it's half price for both of us and it just works out well. And so she met Bobo for the first time. And she's like, he's a little chunky. And I'm like, listen. Bobo. Oh my God, Bobo. What are you doing? Precious. Okay, listen to me. Listen. Okay, can we get off the keyboard? He's gonna bite me. Can we get off? Are you being nice? Can we get off the keyboard? Thank you. You're such a good boy. He's such a good boy. Maybe someday you can show us some of your makeup collection. You know what, Jeanette? I have pared down so much of it. I've kept the high-end stuff. But if you look at it, like, number-wise, it's pitiful. But it's... Even the stuff that I have, I don't even use half of it. But I love it, so I'm not gonna let it go. you too? Yeah. Yeah, it's something... remember when YouTube first started? And it was like this whole thing... with just the makeup, you know? And everything was about makeup. Makeup. And I fell into that trap for a while. I did. I spent too much money on Dior lipsticks and Dior lipsticks have gone up so much. The last time that I remember buying a Dior lipstick was €33 and now it's 44 or 42? What? But so the plan is I am going to try and deal with this mess and that mess. And I hate adulting. No, I see. You know what? Here's the thing. I need to sell enough screenplays. I need to make enough money so that I can hire people to do shit for me. That's my life goal. I need someone to cook for me. My kitchen is... Bobo! Bobo? No, that's an empty pasta packet. I need someone to cook for me. I need someone to clean for me. What else can they do for me? I need someone to drive me because I don't drive. I hate driving. So, and you know, people are like, oh, you may be so spoiled. The thing is, I subscribe to the philosophy that if you hate doing something and you can outsource it, why not? No, tell me, why not? Right? So, that's why I have a two-year plan to make money. Lots of money. So that I can outsource certain things. Anyone else have anything going on in their lives right now? God, that was a deep question. Sorry. What's up with you guys? Sorry, it's the wine talking. I'm gonna have to put on some heavy metal so that I can get shit done. Why is it so dark? That's why. Because I made it dark. So, is there anything else? What I will do is I'm gonna stop this live stream and come back later on. I don't know what I'm saying. I'm gonna stop the live stream and I'm gonna come. Yes, I listen to Eminem. Are you kidding me? He's a god. Oh my god. Hold on one second. We gotta do some research on this. Okay. Eminem. Hang on, Mockingbird. What was the name of the song where he sang about his mother? Was it? It's not Mockingbird. That was about his daughter, right? Without Me, Stan, Godzilla, Rap God. Wait, mother song. Let's just do that. Mother song. There you go. Cleaning out my closet. Oh, yes. He put it out 14 years ago. 14 years ago, that doesn't sound right. It must have been more. But that was the song that made me realize that it's okay to not have good feelings about your mother. And I was shocked. I was astounded by his lyrics about how he described his mother and her behavior. And I thought, holy shit, you can say these things? You can say these things out loud about your mother? It was incredible. It was a turning point in my life. Oh, so yeah. So all the new stuff, Kamikaze. Hang on, let's do some Kamikaze. Hold on a second. All these ads, come on.
Step back on. Okay. Fact. I don't want to say this. Fact. Last year. Fact. Didn't work out so well for me. Fact.
Last year. Oh my god.
2018. Fact. Well. Fact. Yeah, I'm a fucking kamikaze crashing into everything. You beat me, Islamic Nazi, that means there is no such thing. I've been going for your juggler since Greg G. Duck Alert. Wedgie in my underwear, the whole bedsheet in the comforter. Stuck up in my rectal crack, kiss my disrespectful ass. I ride through your cul-de-sac, window crack, open your reference tracks. You collaborative effort rap, I have never said his raps. Overstayed my welcome, stepped in crap and ruined your welcome mess. I spit that shit from the heart, you didn't write like you wrote it. Well, I teabagged the microphone, cause I go nuts on it. Like a fighter jet, my explosives, they'll strike any moment. Headed right at opponents, and I'm the fucking pilot that flown it. I'm about to smash into everyone, crash into everything. Back, and I've just begun. Back, 2017. Back on everyone. Back on everyone. Back on everyone.
Doesn't it just make you wanna like, oh, kill the world? Back on everyone, back on everyone,
back on everyone. I turned to rap cause it made me feel tough when I wasn't. From the moment I heard rappers cussing, I wasn't. Which is why I identify with the guy who I was invented by. Dre's Frankenstein, energized like a 9-volt. Ice cold like snake eyes, twice in a row on a dice roll. But if the only reason I blowed is cause I'm white, though I don't every other white rapper sell what I sold. Kamikaze pilot, I wrote my suicide note. Here come the guys in white coats trying to stop me before I jump behind the controls and try to fly in the phones. Cause I'm taking y'all with me when I go cyclone. I don't think this typhoon's letting up anytime soon. Here I go, ice cold, blindfolded, I'm about to smash into everyone, crash into everything. Back, and I've just begun. Back, 2017. Back on everyone. Back on everyone. Back on everyone. Smash into everyone, crash second F-15. Damage already done. Y'all should've let me be fat. Back on everyone, back on everyone, back on everyone.
Oh yeah.
I heard your freestyle on C-45. That shit was embarrassing. There is no way we ever hear that shit again. I guarantee that. Wait, that shit was so ass. It's something we wouldn't dare re-air. That shit's embarrassing. It's me rearing terror repair in my therapy chair. My dick is the hair like the sheriff. He's known as the chair with the open acorns. Nail if he wear me. Lyrically, I'm terrible. Better get your lyrics prepared. Richard Ramirez is here. Serial killing every beat there. Wait, got the eeriest feeling something evil is lurking. I'm no conspiracy theorist, but something here is afoot. Oh yeah, it's my dick, get that measuring stick. What? 12 inches of wood, but I've been going for your juggler since Greg G. Duck Alert. And I've come to pay respects, cause if you sleep, you're fucked. Other words, you get laid to rest. And I hope your butt is hurt. Put me on a track, I go play on it like a color book. You got some views, but you're still below me, mine are higher. So when you compare our views, you get overlooked. And I don't say the hook unless I wrote the hook. And now I'm just freestyling in the vocal booth. And you know I've always spoke the truth. You're lying through your teeth so much you broke a tooth. And it ain't something I need a phone to do. When I say I can't wait till I get a hold of you. And I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Line up the rappers, take my pic like a photo shoot.
That last line. Take my pic like a photo shoot. This is, Eminem is what I aspire to be as a writer. And so I'm working on this script with my writing partner in Germany. And the way that she rewrote dialogue, so I've got, okay. Okay. So I've got dialogue, the art of verbal action for the page, stage, and screen. It's a really dry and boring book by Robert McKee. Robert McKee is very well known for his work, but it's really dry. And then I got this, and I haven't started it yet, but it's by Linda Seeger, and I've read her before, and she wasn't bad, and it's You Talking to Me? So, dialogue is a really hard thing to write, because you have to be, sorry if I'm geeking up, if I'm geeking out on the writing stuff, but dialogue is a really tricky thing to get down. And whenever I listen to Eminem, I just get inspiration. It's not that I want to write what he writes. It's not that I want to write the way that he writes, but the energy that he has in his speech, there is something to it, you know? You know what? I think I need more wine. There will be people who would say, I don't need more wine, and they would be correct. But I think I need more wine. What I really need to do is write and read. I don't know what happened this week. Remember I had this whole meltdown with my passion planner? I don't know what's going on. How about I stop this live stream for now? I regroup myself. Figure shit out. Yeah, the two don't go together. Figure shit out or figure things out. One of those things. And then I'll come back, and hopefully you guys will be back. All right. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll see you really soon. Okay. Okay. Bye.